Underneath, and it's a change ribbon one, and then And it's also dry as well. Does it take a lot to keep it like this? I mean, obviously you treat the copper and the grass and everything like that. Do you have to spend a lot of hours maintaining it? There we are. Well, yes, and they both enjoy it, and they bring it every year, and it's a pleasure to see it. And is there anything still like this company in Leeds or not? Is there anything, any history where it was made in Leeds?
I never went to the freezer.
Well, thank you for telling us that, because we all tend to tell me, do they employ any braking system, or is it merely on cutting the power and then waiting to stop, or is there any brakes?
Yes, there's a band brake.
Right, a band brake. As I've said to other people, you know what a band brake is, we don't. Tell us what's meant by a band brake.
Oh, of course.
Yeah, let's learn. Right, we've got that now then. So wooden brake pads, power spare, and as he tightens that on, it's the same as applying pressure like that, but obviously you would need a constant pressure with something like this to get it to be, to work. We wouldn't be able to manually operate it, would we? Yeah, it's quite effective. Good, yeah, because it learns us all. Right, do you reckon this young man knows anything about his engine? Is he a busy?
He's looking black. Is this yours? It is it? Oh, is he making you do all the work? No. Oh, well. Right. This, now then.
A little one. Tell us a little bit about this one, if you go. Right. And are you hoping that somebody's going to follow on? Oh, do you like it? Do you like coming to these shows? Good lad, yeah, because we need the younger ones to follow on. And then you can look as happy as this chap here sitting here, you see, there you go. Right, now, in this modern world of health and safety,
Engine.
The engine is going forward and the brake is forward.
holding standing on it, and he's disappeared at the end there. Is that the attic? That's your machine? Right, so the gentleman said about that one, was that a 3-inch scale? Is that one somewhere midway or what? Could you tell us? What would that be used for? Because clearly, this is that check if something is designed correctly, whereas that looks capable of contributing in some work for children.
I've got two mates with me, but I've lost it.
Right, as you can see, ladies and gents, we've got the commercials coming in now, and got some local wagons. This one, the spent most of working life, out of the Manera Quarry, owned by Owen's Timber Transport, the commercials. You've got three or four at the top there. You probably see the other vehicles, or the tippers, flatbeds coming to the ring now. Are you going round again, Ivan? Go round again then. We'll line you up back up here afterwards. This has been a recent restoration in the last couple of years. I think it did come to the event last year. Another club member, which is a recent purchase by Paul Williams, Scott's Grey Little Coach. Was huge from the East Coast, which you could bring them across to Blackpool. I think you're going to bring it round. Very nice. I'll catch you in a minute. Some more information. Great working van back in his day. One of the original Ford Transits. Pick up from a builder's wagon. Very popular in the 70s and 80s. Quite a rarity now to see one of those on the road. Another local member from Manera, or Coat Boy. Stratford, the bus company. Their original recovery vehicle. Nice Thames. That's it, keep working around the ring. There we've got a nice display now, nice ERF tractor unit. Afternoon. Another great exhibit, nice Volvo tractor unit. Full restoration, nut and bolt restoration the last couple of years. Absolutely stunning. A modern classic. A nice photo. Yeah, take it round. We'll get you parked up in a minute. I'll come to you in a minute. Another one of the old ones is Tipper. Oh, Coat Boy, how are we doing? Alright? And this is one of the very first ones that the Owens has had. It belongs to Ivor Owen, who is the father. and started back in the 50s. Ivan, back over here. No, that looks like this, just the four of them. Go on, Langos, do one more lap, and then we'll park you up.
Yeah, you can, yeah, quick then.
Go on, Ray, yeah, go round once more.
There's a pool at the bottom.
1955 Series 1, 86 inch. Yeah. 2 1/4 petrol, that one, I think. Nice little 80 as well. Series 3. Intimate relations this has been into. So yeah, I can see what... Make your own mind up. Cheers for ringing along, thank you. Afternoon. How are we doing, all right? Let me tell me about your Leyland.
This is a 1948 Leyland Beaver. It's an X-area vehicle, which would have been an X-ray vehicle going around the old hospitals in the 50s and 60s. Got a Leyland 600 engine. High-speed boxer, this one's got a transfer box on, living quarters on the back, and then there is a trailer box as well.
So when you say transfer box, does that mean, is it four-wheel drive, or is that reduction gear?
No, it's a gearbox, it's a step-up box, really. It's a gearbox, it's the original gearbox. Just to this vehicle,
Where are you? Are you? Yeah, so you're outside the big club again, are you?
These now, you're very, very good on the road. They are a modern classic. So thank you for taking it. You're doing a good job. Afternoon, sir. How are we doing? Very good. Dawn is gleaming as gorgeous as last year. I know we walked around last year, not a lot less duration. You can tell the ladies and gents behind us, the sort of time, scale, the amount of parts we're putting through.
Well, the parts,
Have you ever worked this? As you can see, the livery on this, have you done the paintwork on it?
I do.
So 86 years old, he's done all this by hand, all the sign writing. Again, that is an art, which you're very rarely see. There's not many upcoming artists or sort of do livery like that anymore. Oh, well, our transfers, aren't they?
Yeah.
So when you say, well, I was from Crestview last year, when we say nut and bolt, it was literally nut and bolt. It was stripped down into thousands of pieces and sort of rebuilt again. And I think it was re-chromed.
No.
It was all of the chrome of the original.
engine work on it?
It has been rebuilt. The engine's good, so no oil leaks on it.
Fantastic. Thank you for coming. Cheers, thank you. We've got here another track unit in the RS. Afternoon. How are you doing, all right? Very good. Can you tell me about the RS track unit?
The 1980 Vintage Series.
Rolls Royce engine, you say? Rolls Royce, as in, you know, did with these 50 it doesn't have to use it. Have you had it a long time?
I've only had this about 3 months after.
So, with a bit of sleeping cab, obviously, at the back, ladies and gentlemen, it's got the. Like this one here, it's got the short back to it, which is an over-gate cab. This one with a sleeper cab, it's deeper, and it allows a person to sleep across the back. Usually get like a bunk in the back here. What other facilities have you got inside?
Well, it's got two bunks in it. I use the top bunk for storage and the bottom bunk for sleeping.
Yeah. Right, okay. And where did it originate from? What was it used for?
General Hall, it's the original owner was Carl Henderson from Alston in Cumbria. That's used on General Hall. It's set up on the other owners think on General Hall.
Right, okay. Yeah, it's still great. So, is there any other sort of work that needs doing to it, or
dark green?
You know, are you happy with it as it is?
Well, more or less, there's always something that you want to do to personalise, you know, little things like shock absorbing.
And I'll have this Rolls Royce engine now. What sort of miles per gallon would you get?
Probably about 8, I would think.
Maybe
a bit more. I've not worked it out, so I say
not
yet, not really. But I would think about between 8
and
maybe 10 at the most, you know.
Which is about average, really, for a lot of these tractor units and lorries in general. That's great. Thank you for coming along. Thank you.
Yes, bro, it is, really.
Afternoon. How are we doing, all right? Very good. Can you tell me a little bit about this, please?
69
DC, whereas.
Spent most of my life in Bristol, the docks, shunting, and was converted to recovery
a few
years ago.
Right, okay. I'm wondering which problem. Well, thank you for bringing it along. Cheers. Again, a bit of a rarity. You don't see many of these left in the road now. Do you? Quite a short wheelbase as well, isn't it? So has it had a fifth wheel on the back at one time, or?
No. It's always been the short wheelbase.
Afternoon, you okay? Very good. Transit pickup, or as in a builder's pickup? What was this used for? As a builder's pickup? How long have you had it for?
Double trouble. This was a scrapper 4 years ago.
Really?
Yeah, it was going to go for scrap, break for spares. So
you had it all renovated?
I rescued it, yeah.
Well, congratulations to you.
Took 2.5 years.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We won't talk about money.
Did you do the water machine? How long have you had it? How long have you had it?
And
Yeah, Land Rover, Land Rover steering, can we get the Land Rover in the get ready? Call the Land Rover in after the first
I mean, we've just got to
do just get one move. Yeah, we didn't get a fucking move.
Military and Land Rovers.
They are commercial, bring them round. Thank you for displaying. We'll see you all again tomorrow.
Charlie, don't throw. Listen to me. Don't throw by the car.